Writing the Cup is without question the high point of my professional career, but just as importantly, it was extremely rewarding on a personal basis. And I say that because it took me so many places and introduced me to so many incredible characters. Obviously, going to Ireland, the land of my forefathers, was a very rewarding experience personally. Going to Dubai and seeing how that country is changing the landscape of the Middle East with Sheikh Mohammed, being able to meet and catch up with him and talk about his goals of winning the Melbourne Cup. And believe me, he is still intent on winning the Cup, regardless of the number of times he has to come here. I also got to meet in Dubai. I thought it was quite interesting that I got to meet Kieran McAvoy, who gave me some wonderful insights, particularly the pre-race insights before going out into the field. As we all know, he ran such a great race on Beekeeper then, which is how he ended up with the Dubai, with Godolphin, with the Godolphin stables. But the one who really stands out in Dubai is Frankie Dettori, because it was for, obviously, I was there for the Dubai World Cup, and the press was asking him all sorts of questions about the Dubai World Cup, and I eventually got him aside and said I'd like to talk to him a little bit about the Melbourne Cup, and he looked at me and I started asking some questions, and he said, "Why are you talking about that race? We're in Dubai, okay? I win races in Dubai, I win races in England, I win races in America, and you want to talk about a race I lose in Australia?" I said, "Frankie, that's okay. If you don't want to talk about it, that's fine." Because Sheikh Mohammed talked to me for about 10 or 15 minutes about the Melbourne Cup and how Godolphin is intent on winning it. But if you don't want to talk about it, that's fine. Frankie looked at me and he said, "Two questions, keep them short." Going to Australia, Australia's the mother load. I mean, the characters there, the George Hanlons, the Lee Friedmans, Bart Cummings. I'm so thankful Bart is not my editor. He summed up the race in one sentence. Damien got on a good horse and changed his bad luck. Okay, not a 256-page book. We're talking about a one-sided pamphlet that will no doubt be a bestseller. Working with Simon not only on the book, but working on the script and being able to understand the entire process to bring something like this to fruition. A, from the book standpoint, but B, from the movie standpoint. I think it's been I consider it a tutorial to have worked with such a leading director as closely on such a major project. The last step of the book, which I think was the most important step, was you've got all these facts, you've got all these figures and characters and anecdotes, but who do you bring them to? And that's where Jeff Slattery and Danny Power and Allie Herbert Burns made all the difference in bringing this book to life. Because these people know Victoria Racing. I mean, Allie had a share in Promiscuous. I mean, these people, Jeff and Danny, they've been covering racing for decades. Danny was a part of the Friedman organization right when it was launching. And so to take this project to them and to have them nurture it is part of the key reason for its success and for my complete satisfaction with the way the book's turned out.